Okay, so yeah, thank you. I'll try today to give you, in a nutshell, a very quick overview of a bit of the context of how at Clarin we are using vocabulary platforms and all kind of related repositories. As introduced, I'm Dieter van Hetvan, kind of technical director of Clarin, and I'll try to, quickly give this overview. So first, a bit of history. We've been using all kind of concept registries already for quite a while, and I saw that many of the people today in the online meeting also have contributed actually to the creation of some of these platforms. So in 2008, we started with a platform called IsoCat for the registration of data categories. This platform was running until 2015. There were over 1,000 entries in there, many of them translated, of which a lot of effort was put into creating these translations, into creating the definitions, into having a whole organizational framework around it, including kind of ISO stamp of approval on certain of these groups of concepts. Now, that concept was left apart around 2015, when we moved on with OpenSCoS for two different purposes. First of all, there is the Clarin Concept Registry, which was kind of a direct follow-up of some of the content categories from IsoCat. So they were migrated into this concept registry. And this registry contained mostly definitions of what the specific metadata field, for instance, means. So if you're talking about a title or a description or something else, then these metadata fields were linked to a definition in the concept registry, and that's still the case. So this fits within the broader metadata framework, CMDI, which we are using at Clarin. In addition to that, the Clavas vocabulary service was launched also based on OpenSCoS, largely inspired by the colleagues from the Dutch Clarin or Claria project. Also still around, you can find the URL here. Was launched in 2017 with the idea of basically providing support for, say, longer or larger controlled vocabularies to be entered, for instance, in metadata descriptions. So in such a way that if you wanted to select a language code from the, what is it, 8,000 somewhat ISO 63993 language codes, that you could just use type ahead and get support from that on the side of this vocabulary service. And at this time, it's 2020 in meanwhile, we're looking for a follow-up platform because it seems that OpenSCoS, well, the development of it has kind of stalled, and we think the situation now is actually good to look around for alternatives. And that's also why it is so interesting to be here today and to have seen the previous presentation sessions on vocabulary services, because they're very timely in that sense. Okay, what are our requirements? Well, first of all, we're looking for an open source solution that's about sustainability, but it's also about the more philosophical backing of our software development and maintenance efforts, in that we are trying to not to reinvent the wheel, but also that we, with whatever we're doing, trying to recontribute to the broader domain, and not to let those development efforts being focused around one single thing, but that we can contribute back to the software development landscape, so to say. It should be in line with common standards costs. I think that's a no-brainer. A reasonable migration path from OpenSCoS, that's also a very important part, since we currently do have to repositories where we are using OpenSCSS. Ideally, the solution should come with a GUI and an editor, also because it would allow to make changes, make updates, provide new content without having to go through, say, a technical person in between. Should be mature solution, so not something that is very experimental and still in some early alpha version. For the support of all kind of editors, the API should be faster. You should be able to, for instance, when doing a type ahead detection, should be quick enough to respond quickly. Well, it's not so exotic. It should, and that also relates to the next point. The software stack shouldn't be too exotic. I mean, depending on who is going to maintain this, but there's a large probability that this would happen somewhere within the Clarin network. We would like to avoid very specific or difficult to maintain software stacks. Ideally, it should also be support for persistent identifiers. I'm mentioning that because, for instance, in our Clarin concept registry, we have handles for each entity, and it would be very nice if a next solution would be compatible with that, or at least would have some possibilities for integrating those so that we can maintain those persistent identifiers. And obviously, also some support for multilinguality. I mean, it's been mentioned enough before in the presentations today, so I don't need to go into that. But for instance, maintaining translations is a nice feature, as difficult as it is sometimes is. I mean, we have seen that with IsoCat at the time. It's sometimes quite tricky to maintain a large amount of translations when the content actually in your concept registry is still changing. Now, then moving on to not really requirements, but wishes or dreams. So maybe a bit broader or a bit more wishful thinking. But what I think would be nice to have is to have some know-how and experience about the platform available through a Clarin Center. Or a nearby organization. For instance, some of our consortia have close collaborations with national libraries, and I think it would make a lot of sense to have some access through the expertise or sharing know-how and issues and problems and solutions together with those players. Ideally, a solution would also come with some major vocabularies preloaded. I mean, we all are aware about long vocabulary lists like the language codes or MIME types or what have you. And I mean, it would be very nice if we could just reuse something that has already been entered in such a system. Support for kind of clustering or management of groups of entities would also be nice, because then you could basically delegate that to a specific subgroup, making sure that this or that vocabulary is maintained and kept up to date. And of course, also nice to have would be a broad developers base with long-term perspectives. And it's not always very easy to get an assurance of this, of course, but I think it's an important thing for the sustainability and being able to share some part of the development really can bring a lot of advantages. How do we see potential alignment between the different vocabulary platforms? Well, I think there should be place for multi-directional synchronization to avoid double curation work. There should be possibilities for linking to external, say, authority files, for instance, rather than having to redefine something within your system. And ideally, something like compatible access APIs for different systems. I mean, I think that would definitely also be something that could try to solve a lot of the potential issues. And then finally, how do we see the possibilities to address interoperability challenges between the vocabularies? Well, first of all, I think it would be very nice if we could reuse existing vocabularies wherever possible. I mean, trying to avoid reinventing the wheel makes a lot of sense, especially if you see how much curation efforts there already have been done and are actually openly available through the internet. Relying on well-curated vocabularies with lots of, I mentioned it here as the same as links, but trying to identify things that are also defined elsewhere and then being explicit about it. I think that is really useful. And finally, I think it's important to, and that's also personally something I've learned over the past 10 years, that it's important rather than trying to define everything yourself as a community, trying to rely as much as possible for those things that you don't need to strictly define yourself, standing on the shoulders of the giants, and trying to avoid the reinvention of the wheel. And so realizing that, for instance, libraries have done enormous amounts of curation and trying to make use of that, linking to authority files wherever possible, for instance, VIAF, and finally also try to actively contribute the outcomes of our community curated entries to the larger open data community, so to say, in that sense that we don't keep things isolated in one, our specific community themed repository, but we actively try to contribute the outcomes of that hard and labor intensive curation process back towards a larger community. And with those wishes or hopes, I would like to conclude my presentation and thank you for your attention.